And I'm recording.
Wow, let's get blowing.
I'll smash you, dude.
Oh, no, my hernia.
Oh, it's up.
Hit it. Skills.
Well done, Mr. Burnley.
Kill the camera.
We've got a score for all the cameras.
But I would like some action shots around there.
Oh, it's in the goal.
Of course it's in the goal. That's the safest place.
Thank you.
One after the other. Oh. No.
Hey, can you have that
gun? This one's again.
To cover the clay with the barrel,
yeah.
On the trigger. Show, pull for me.
Pull.
Bang.
Yo.
Oh, sorry.
Catch that one. Pull.
Bang. Bring the second one. Bang. Just over the top.
Incoming bird.
Cool. I will never tell you if you've hit it or vice versa. If you just missed it, I'll tell you you missed it.
What's right,
two shots coming from up there.
Cool.
Bang on, I want you to pull the trigger next time. There it is, bang. That gives you an idea. Yeah, just the one from the top of the hill. Oh. Two of them. Oh. head down, left eye shut. Here it is. Go back to your original plan, touching it, coming down. Hold. Touch the clay and come down. Well done.
Hey. Well done.
If you stand sideways on, the gun tends to come out on the bottom of your shoulder. If you're a bit facing the front, bring that foot forward. A bit more. That's it. It goes up into the pocket into there. That's it. Head down on that gun. Perfect. Okay. Moving somewhere there. Check for when you're ready.
Just over looking just that way.
Just over the top of the barrel.
Cool.
Cool. Bang.
Got it.
You are probably a fraction high. There's a danger there that bird comes out beneath the barrel. Two of those, they've started the barrel a fraction lower.
Head down on that gun. If it's a bee, kind of above it.
Fine. Got it.
Look.
Okay, right. Are you closing an eye and you're shooting all going away?
Oh, it's probably dozing. Oh.
Yeah, well, I can't do that. You've got to close your left one if you want. I'm not both of them. Right, follow that. I want you to touch it at its peak and come down a fraction.
Cool.
Right. Follow it up, touch it, and come down a bit. And again. Follow it up, touch it, and come down. It's like a paintbrush. You imagine it's a paintbrush and you'll paint it to pull the trigger and carry on brushing. Two bees, please. Okay, Paul.
Move ahead a bit, move.
Good. Move in.
Move ahead a bit.
Bee bang A, please. Okay, Paul.
Touch the clay.
Okay, Paul.
Move ahead of it. Touch the clay.
Got it.
Rabbit time. Starting there.
Right. Head down like that. Button B with the shape pull.
Paul.
Right, now move ahead of it. Move ahead of it. That was quicker than I thought.
It's actually slowing down. The reason I've started you boys further to the right of it is that it's slowing down. Two rabbits, one after the other. No, don't start there, start there. Pull!
Move ahead of it.
Right, it's a bit wider. There's no one there.
Never even saw
head
it.
Head down
and
forward.
Take four, you ready.
Pull!
Move ahead of it.
I'm having trouble seeing it, honestly.
Can I put it back on then?
No, I'm alright. I think I'll carry on without.
It's just different shots. Back and forth. The very focus catches you between two lenses. Sideways doesn't. So it's different, isn't it?
Yeah.
Right, rabbit followed by the other one.
Pull.
Yeah, touch the clay.
Yeah. Got it.
Put
ahead
of it, put ahead of it.
Just behind you, behind you.
Right, next shot, more of it. Okay then?
Yeah.
Pull. Move ahead of it. Oh, another man! Oh, dear.
Pull.
Right, now move ahead of it. I think I was just over the top of that. Very close. Rabbit followed by the A bird. That one.
Yeah.
Start there.
Alright, yeah.
Shoot it by here.
Yeah.
Pull.
Move ahead of it, move by.
No bird, don't fire. Just saw that one again. Bang. That was unfortunate. You didn't see that one coming, did you?
No,
I knew that.
Pull. Pull ahead of it.
Yeah. Now touch the clay. Bang. Oh. Just let it drop. Who's on next?
Pull.
Got it.
Very easy. Right, the rabbit time now. rushed off the hill. Yeah. So you,
try and track it.
Yeah.
Two rabbits.
Go.
Up the left one. Where about your shoulders? Yeah, that shouldn't actually come above the shoulders. Back in that way towards you. That's it.
Oh! Where did that one go?
Cool.
Probably behind you.
Cool.
Move ahead a bit.
Yeah. And again.
Move ahead a bit.
Yeah. Wow.
This time.
Rabbit followed by A, please.
Cool. Move ahead a bit.
Off target.
So long as you leave that through. The rabbit, the harvest gets for the right hand of the person.
I thought it was bouncing, so I was going to wait for it to calm down.
Cool.
Touch the clay.
Oh, got it.
Now, the reason why I asked you to sign that is because if we see it again later, we know it's yours. All right, and I use the word it. Andy, I'll take the pen back. It's not that I don't trust you, but they are a pound each. And I wanted to show everybody your note with your signature on. Fantastic.
Yeah.
Now, Andy, will you give me that five? Excellent. I use the word give. So if we don't see this again, you can't ask for it back. We've got a room full of witnesses saying you're being it. All right? But watch very carefully, okay? We're going to take this $5 and we're going to fold it up. Okay. As I fold up, do not take your eyes off of the note. Okay? Yeah. Try and confuse you a few times just to see if you're paying attention. And you are, that's good. But remember, you've been drinking tonight?
Yes.
Andy, remember, the more pissed you are, the more magic I become. I'm going to place this into my very cute purse. Do you know how I know it's a cute purse? Because it says it's a unicorn jumping over a rainbow with the word cute. You can't get much cuter than that, right? I'm going to put this in here, and what I get you to do, Andy, is hold on to it with your finger and thumb like so. We are going to go shopping with that money, okay? This is, I've made a prediction to what I think you're going to choose on the shopping journey, okay? You can lower it down a bit, it's all right, it's not, ah! It's all right. Just hold it naturally. I made a prediction for what I think you're going to choose, but I don't want you to see it, okay? So I want you to turn yourself and face that wall, okay? Do not look behind you. I'm going to show everybody what I think you're going to choose on this magical shopping journey, okay? Please don't shout out, people, because if you shout out, it goes from a prediction to just telling him what's in the fucking bag, all right? But I think Andy is going to choose one of these. You are right to go, ooh.
Ooh!
I know. Andy, you can turn around now, buddy. And what we're going to do is we're going to leave that there for everyone to keep an eye on. Okay? Now, Andy, I have several things of what we can buy on our shopping journey on these cards. I'm going to show the audience each of these cards, okay? If they think it's a good thing for you to buy, they might go, ooh. If it means a shit thing to buy, they might go, oh. And if they don't give a fuck, Andy, if they don't give a fuck, they'll do this.
What the? Okay.
Alright, calm down. Okay, now. But we only have about 7 or 8 cards. One of the cards that you want to have, just say stop, and that's the thing we'll buy. Okay? So on our shopping journey, Andy, you and I could buy one of these.
Ooh.
Or one of these.
Ooh.
Or one of these.
Ooh.
Or one of these.
Ooh.
This one or this or for the next?
I'll go for that one.
Okay, so Andy, I want you to hold that up to your chest. Don't. Perfect. But you can choose any one of them. Andy, I don't want to see it. Make sure I don't see it, but I want you to have a little look at it and then hide it again. Look at it and then hide it. I think this item's not very big.
It's not.
I think this item fits in your hand.
It would.
Good, because if you chose the car, I'd struggle. I don't think this item costs very much.
It
doesn't. Jim, how much would you say one of these costs?
50 cents.
50 cents. Depends on where you shop. Nice and loudly, for those who didn't see the card, nice and loudly, tell everyone what you have!
Lemon.
Then fuck off. Tell everyone what you have!
Lemon!
Hey. Lemon!
Tell everyone what you have!
And
no problem, because it's a prediction, Andy. It's a prediction, and I've been beating the lottery for years and I still haven't won. So don't feel too disappointed. I thought you were going to choose the lemon.
Yay!
But I wanted this trip to be my fucking money. You told me that one of these cost 50 cents. With the $5 you brought up, that would be $4.50 change, wouldn't it? In a moment! You're going to tip out $4.50 and the crowd will go fucking mental.
No. Yeah.
Hold out your hand, tip out the contents into your hand. There should be $4.50.
And unicorn cents.
You said it depends on where you shop. In America, you've never heard of the dollar store. But they've got something else, which is much better than ours. They've got a $5 store. Anything for $5. Figuratively and literally, Andy, thanks so much for the $5. I've never seen that fucking impression. Can I do one more thing?
Go ahead.
Insert it.
Shut the front door!
No!
Andy, I'm going to cut open this thing.
No
way.
No! Twist it. Pull it, you'll see there's something inside. Not only is it a $5, but it's a $5 with your name.
No!
Thank you so much. Give Andy a massive round of applause! Are you happy there?
Yeah.
Are you sure you're happy? I want to make sure that you're happy there, because when you're in bed tonight and you roll over to me and say, Rich, that's a fantastic time. Nick, I'm going to give you that one last chance. Just stay there. Just sit there. Okay. Now, Nick, I'm going to take this card. Now, it's very important that I do not see it. It's very important that nobody else sees it. This card is just for you. Nick, reach in and grab your card. Look at it, remember it, commit it to memory, and then place it somewhere where I cannot retrieve it. That usually means a pocket.
No.
Is it secured away?
Butt crack.
Put it somewhere where you can't get it.
In your butt. Under your butt.
Make sure that nobody else sees it, Nick. Is it gone?
Yeah.
Nick, that was a bit weird. You just stole it in the hat for a while. If I was to guess your card right now, I don't think that would get you to that level 3, would it? Because I reckon you think I'd be some of those jiggery pokery hocus pocus shit, yeah? So, I said to you earlier that mind reading is bullshit. It is. But the ability to send a thought is not. You're going to send your thought off card to somebody in this audience. So what was your name?
Jordan.
Jordan, do you know Nick?
I don't.
Nick, do you know Jordan?
No.
Good, because if one of you says yes, it turns weird. Nick, you're going to send your thought of cards to Jordan. I have something called the Thought Transmitter 2000. Dan?
Yep.
The Thought Transmitter 2000.
1000.
Thank you. Nick, using the Thought Transmitter 2000.
1000.
You're going to send your to Jordan. Jordan, all you're going to do is stay sat there, but come with us on this journey.
Okay.
Okay, sounds incredible, yes? Can you pick up the Thought Transmitter? It's that metal bit in there. Lovely. Now, this is the thought transmitter. So careful.
Oh my word.
The reason why it looks like a normal household whisk is because I left it on the table and fucked off. When I come back, I know it'll still be there.
Yeah, of course.
If that looked like thousands of pounds worth of equipment with bells, whistles, wires and buzzers on it, and I left it on the table and fucked off, when I come back, I know it'll be gone. It'll be nicked. This is Bristol. But I do have the instructions for the thought transmitter device. Now, Jordan, we're just going to go for the colour of the card, okay? So come stand next to me, Nick. So step one, locate the thought transmitter's handle. Step two, place the thought transmitter on your forehead. Step three, place the person which to transmit your thoughts to. Step four, spin the handle, crank up the transmitter. Now, Jordan, the colour of the card will come flying at you. Don't shout it out. Let it wash over you. Let it wash over you, the colour of the card. Okay, stop, Jordan. What colour is next card?
Black.
Is it black? Okay, it's not a problem. I was the one that fucking chose it. Alright? So we're gonna go for the suit. Another 50-50 chance. Okay? The suit. It's either going to be hearts or diamonds.
Okay.
Okay. So if Jordan says clubs or spades, he's just being a dick. Okay. Now I think I know what happened. We didn't do step five. So step one, locate the thought transmitter's handle. Step two, place the thought transmitter on your forehead. Step three, face the person you're transmitting your thoughts to. Step four, spin the handle, crank up the transmitter. And step five, Nick, squat and rise until your thoughts have been set. That's it, that's lovely. So you're going to get the soup come flying at you, Jordan. Just let it wash over you. Let it wash over you. Don't shout it out. Don't shout it out. Jordan, what suit is Nick's card?
Hearts.
Is it hearts?
Yeah.
Fuck yes! I think that's not got you to that level.
Kissing.
You're like, yeah, whatever. But no, okay. I need to get you to this level three. We're going to send the whole card now to everybody here.
All right.
So when you squat and rise,
yeah,
make sure you make eye contact with as many people as you possibly can.
Okay.
Whoa. Then you go through the steps.
Okay.
Step one, locate the thought transmitter's handle. Step two, place the thought transmitter on your forehead. Step three, face the people you wish to transmit your thoughts to. Step four, spin the handle, crank up the transmitter. And step five, squat and rise until your thoughts have been set. Let's do this! Woo! Oh, yeah! Can you feel it? Can you feel it? Oh, yes! Eye contact, Nick! Can you feel it? Oh, my goodness, Nick!
Oh, yeah!
We're going to stop there because, look, I don't want you to look silly. If the majority of them get it right, you do two things for me. The first thing is to take out the card and show them. The second thing is to say two words. I believe. What are the two words? Now, you came up here as a two. Yes? Yeah?
Yes,
if you leave as a one and you hate magic, you would do this.
I believe.
And fuck off. If I kept you at two, be more of a chuckle. I believe. If I got you to that level three, loud and proud, I believe! And if I got you to the point where you're not going to sleep for a week, I don't know what's going to happen. All I ask, Nick, is you keep your clothes on. Audience, what was Nick's card?
Yeah!
Six hearts!
Seven of diamonds!
All together or not at all. What is Nick's card?
Seven of diamonds!
Let's just go with this side.
Three hearts!
Shout out those two fucking words, they can make a big deal of it.
Well, fucking hell.
I believe! Thank you so much, buddy. Give Jake a massive round of applause! Just never tell him how he was fucking done.